Okay, I think I'm recording. This is our house. And the car I did not authorize that my husband bought last year while I was gone. Did not even tell me about it. Sold my truck and bought this beautiful Toyota without even telling me about it. His secret new car is the beautiful fruit trees, the awful old junker Jeep we're giving away. Another Jeep we're giving away. It's nice plum trees and cherries are planted. They're doing well. A pond I built, mountain. Dome greenhouse I designed and built. Our satellite dish. More mountains. John's. That is a man's spot. It's his man cave. It's a little bit scary. It's where he hangs out. Fruit trees, fruit tree orchard, here's the round scope of things. We're on an 8,500-foot mountain. There's the mountain still covered with snow. Old Ford truck, one of our roads. That's our other road. It's a called road. Built by hand. Built. Dug. Some water lines. Moved the house. It's got a seven-sided dome with solariums. That's the four-year solarium. Cross on top, giant freaking trees. If I can even get this one in the hole. These trees are like, to give you an idea, this is our three-story house. This is the tree next to it, which you can't even, there's a rough. That tree is a bit scary. There's a pond I dug myself. It's kind of nice. Got lilies coming up there. Nice lilies. Slowly coming up. I would pick the rockiest spot for like miles to hit the pond. Me years to take that one out. Okay. We are going to walk down. I'm taking on a walk down through. It's actually a road. It's one of our roads. It's starting to rain a little bit here. Got a camera. Isn't that true? Got my husband does security cameras, so if you ever come here, you are being watched. It's his business is selling security cameras. As you can see, the neighbor's cows done away with my garden fence. It came and ran into everything and totally destroyed my garden. These are some trees I planted. Fruit trees, apple trees I planted last year. Let me see. Back away from that house. Another side of our house. third solarium. It's partially underground, the house is, as you can see. That room's pretty much deeper than it appears. It's just like the skylights kind of thing. And that's the mountain. Let me see if I can get closer on that. Mountain. Close to get, there's a monster that lives up there. The Indians won't even come around here because they are fearful of the snowmobile. It's the only way to get out of here in the winter. The house, the bat thingamajig. To collect bats and bat home. Yes, you're a batty. The number two room where we would like folks that are staying here, they have particularly farty poos. I'd much rather them use the old tool two room, the number two room. It's house, outhouse, outhouse. If you're Canadian, outhouse. If you're from West Virginia, like I am. Okay, which way are we gonna go? That is down to where the inlet used to be for our hydro system. It's the backside house where we used to live. We built the front on, there's a dome in the front. And this is the original house, which is actually a fully isolated house of its own now. Actually quite lovely, but there's the one of the fronts of the seven-sided dome. It's a little shack for visitors to stay in. This is actually the first little shack that is here on the place that was built up here before the treehouse burnt up. Okay, we're gonna go down here. I haven't been down here. There's another path in. I haven't been down here for a while. I guess I'll talk a little bit about where my mind's at right now while we're walking. As you know, of the full belief that we live on a not global plane at, it's a little, what used to be a really pretty little Chinese Zen-like bridge, is now in total collapse. These things happen. Whoa. Just fell through the bridge, actually. So I'm gonna be careful. That's what I'm doing here. The bridge is breaking down. This is our stream. It comes from, there's actually, this old volcano the top of this mountain, and this is where we get our hydro from, this stream, going up the stream, many feet up the stream.